contain 80% silver, and so they're actually worth a lot more than 50 cents just by the silver content. So these ones today, you can, well, they buy them online between $10 and $20 for the round 50s. Although if you spent the 50 cents in 1966 rather than saving it, it'd be worth, well, you know, the buying power of it would have been a lot more. You probably could have bought, you know, maybe a, you know, probably a newspaper was only a few cents, I suppose. A loaf of bread might have only been 5 cents, 10 cents, I'm not too sure. But anyway, that's the round 50. What we do in Australia is that we commemorate special events by minting a new front for our 50 cent coins. We've still got the Queen on the back, 1977. But this is to celebrate the Queen's Super Jubilee, Silver Jubilee, 25 years on the throne in 1977. I think she just celebrated her 70th year. So 25 was not that long. Now this one is the Commonwealth Games in Brisbane. There we go, Brisbane. This is from 2000 and, oh, well, even 1982. When the Commonwealth Games were held in Brisbane, so that's the games for all the Commonwealth countries that were or have been part of the British Empire. Countries like Australia, New Zealand, United Kingdom, of course, Canada, India, and those sort of countries. This is another Commonwealth Games. This is Melbourne in 2006, I think it is. Yeah, 2006, it says. It's quite small writing. Oh, there we go. Melbourne 2006 Commonwealth Games, but the coin is from 2005, isn't it? Yeah, 2005. There we go, with the Queen's head on the back. Here she's our head of state. The Queen, Queen Elizabeth II. There we go, it says Elizabeth II. It says she bears on all our coins. This is the marriage of Charles and Diana, Prince of Wales, and Lady Diana Spencer. HRH 50 cents from the good old 1981. That was a long time ago. And a young queen on the back of the coin. This one. This is my favourite one. Well, in some ways it is. I found this 50 cent piece. So you can see it actually is a 50 when you put it next to another one. It is exactly the same size. But I was crossing a major highway. Three lanes one way, three lanes of traffic the other way. And I found that on the road, and I thought, that's been smashed and smashed around by cars for ages. And it's left is a scratched, unrecognizable coin. Even the little edges are all added as well. So, yeah, I thought that was interesting to see how much damage cars could do. I have no idea how long that's been on the road for. Now this one, well, this is the World War II remembrance, finished in 1945. Australia sent troops to Europe, Middle East, and also up to Papua New Guinea, Indonesia, Singapore, those sort of countries, and there we go, 2005, so it must have been remembering 60 years since World War II finished. On this one, I've actually got a lot of these ones in my collection. It's James Cook. So that's James Cook, who was on the ship called the Endeavour, and in 1770 he was the first English man to spot the east coast of Australia. He came in down around here and sailed up the east coast to the top and headed back to England, and then 18 years later the English decided to set the first lot of colony ships, to colonise Australia. So we celebrate that, well, this coin is celebrating 200 years since that happened. Okay. So, that's, I haven't got a great collection of coins, but I've got a few 50 centers, 50 cent pieces for this video. So, yeah, if you enjoyed this video, I'm sure I'll be posting others regularly, so like and subscribe to receive notifications of more videos. Okay, well, thanks for